Nearly a decade ago, the U.S. Army retired its last helicopter designed specifically for the attack reconnaissance mission, the OH-58 Kiowa Warrior. Since then, a combination of AH-64 Apache helicopters and unmanned aerial vehicles, UAVs, have filled in, performing the attack reconnaissance mission the best they could. But near-peer threats demand next-generation aircrafts specially designed to stay ahead of the fight through continuous evolution. Unlike the Kiowa Warrior, the future attack reconnaissance aircraft, FARA, Army Aviation's top modernization priority, is a division, corps, and joint forces-level strategic asset operating deep in the battle space. And it's the only reconnaissance platform that delivers deep reach, providing a level of survivability never before obtained in Army aviation. Delivering mission-critical capabilities at the front of the fight. Sikorsky, a Lockheed Martin company and one of two companies vying for FARA, is offering Raider X. Flying low and fast to stay hidden below the tree line, Raider X will deliver crucial intelligence and keep forces connected through a secure mesh network. Built to find, fix and finish anti-access or anti-denial, A2AD, and enemy forces, Raider X operates in contested environments at the front of the fight. It's a sophisticated sensor, a central network hub, and a powerful armed reconnaissance helicopter all in one. Raider X is a complete weapon system, said Jay Macklin, Sikorsky's director of future vertical lift business development and a retired Army aviator. It provides significant reach, survivability, and lethality much more than exists with today's enduring fleet. Raider X will be plugged into the network as a key part of the combined arms force, enabling the ground commander to see and shape the battlefield. With an increasingly complex future threat environment and swift pace of technological change, enabling rapid upgrades and putting real-time decision-making closer to the fight is critical for mission success. Raider X is purpose-built with the Army's modular open systems approach, MOSA, to provide leap-ahead capability and enable rapid upgrades. Its adaptability is the starting point for decades of innovation. This merger of superior physical performance with transformational digital capabilities is exactly what Lockheed Martin's 21st century security strategy seeks to achieve, helping warfighters meet the challenges of tomorrow's multi-domain missions. Raider X is a complete weapon system. It provides significant reach, survivability, and lethality much more than exists with today's enduring fleet. Raider X will be plugged into the network as a key part of the combined arms force, enabling the ground commander to see and shape the battlefield. Transforming operations in the lower-tier air domain. X2 technology, the foundation of Sikorsky's coaxial rotorcraft design, enables Raider X to fly faster and farther than single-main rotor helicopters while carrying significant payload. The speed, range, and integrated mission systems of Raider X make it an especially effective and improved strategic asset in the vast expanses of the Indo-Pacific region. X2 designs also allow for inherent growth of the weapon system compared to the limitations of single-main rotor aircraft. All of these attributes allow Raider X to operate at greater ranges with superior closing speed to target and a high degree of situational awareness. With its low and high-speed maneuverability, Raider X excels in the lower-tier air domain, LTAD, the space between the ground and 100 feet. Raider X is a network sensor package supporting the joint domain. It significantly extends the battle area's boundaries by scouting, coordinating, and providing feedback through the management and sustainment of launched effects, LE, networks at the tactical edge, providing greater flexibility for the joint force commander. No substitute for a pilot's instincts in the lower-tier air domain. Some are now questioning why manned helicopters are still necessary in the current era, when drones can be relied upon for similar missions. While the use of autonomous vehicles may have its place on the future battlefield, Lockheed Martin insists that the presence of an instinctive pilot in the cockpit remains indispensable in a high-altitude combat environment, LTAD. The future attack reconnaissance aircraft, FARA, program is faced with complex, low-flying missions below treeline, and in this high-risk context, the human role is considered more suitable for making real-time connections and decisions. Helicopter crews provide critical situational awareness for dominance and effective decision-making on the battlefield. Radar X is integrated as a strategic asset for ground commanders. In missions on the front lines of battle, it is capable of deploying and controlling unmanned aerial vehicles, LE, shaping the fight, and returning safely. The aircraft becomes a crucial point in the network, collecting data from various sources such as satellites, other aircraft, and Radar X's mission systems and sensors. Radar X uses fly-by-wire and autonomous systems to increase pilot effectiveness, allowing them to focus on mission objectives. With a natural cockpit interface referred to as Intelligent Co-Pilot, FARA pilots can control the LE fleet, fill gaps in network coverage, and provide unparalleled maneuverability. This gives FARA an edge in using terrain to protect positions and avoid threats. Mick Macklin, a Lockheed Martin representative, emphasized the importance of high-altitude sensors and networks to provide vital intelligence information. Nonetheless, in a dynamic combat environment, manned assets like Radar X can efficiently adapt their tasks to provide the intelligence and situational awareness needed by ground commanders, even when the situation changes or sensors go offline. Macklin added, "Combat is a very dynamic and volatile environment. If a sensor goes down or the situation changes abruptly, as it inevitably will, the ability of a manned asset like Radar X to quickly reassign other assets is crucial. This is to still provide the critical frontline intelligence and situational awareness desired by ground commanders." By maximizing pilot efficiency through the latest technologies, including fly-by-wire systems and advanced cockpit interfaces, Radar X proves itself to be a vital asset on the modern battlefield. Its ability to control unmanned aerial vehicles, collect data from multiple sources, and adapt to situational changes makes it a key element in the defense network. Lockheed Martin Vice President Ed Fortunato stated, "Successful missions for Radar X crews involve utilizing the aircraft as a strategic asset to ground commanders. We believe that a human presence in the cockpit provides not only intelligence, but also an emotional connection and intuitive understanding that is irreplaceable in dealing with complex, high-risk situations." As technology continues to evolve, Radar X demonstrates that the combination of artificial intelligence and human instinct remains an irreplaceable combination on the modern battlefield. As such, manned helicopters like Radar X continue to be the first choice in meeting the demands of increasingly complex and dynamic military tasks. In this context, Lockheed Martin designed Radar X as a holistic solution to meet the military's evolving operational needs. Mick Macklin, a company representative, explains, "Radar X is not just a helicopter, it is an integrated system with capabilities that go beyond just flight and combat missions. It is a step forward in engaging the latest technology to ensure excellence on the battlefield."